When you're drawing, one of the key things to keep in mind is proportion. Whether you're drawing cows, horses, people, buildings, cars, proportions are so important. You know, if you have a cow next to a tree, you can't have the tree trunk bigger than the cow, or else it's going to make the cow look like a puppy. Or if you make the cow so big and the tree trunk looks like a stick, it's not going to look like a tree, it's going to look like a small seedling or something like that. So that's the first thing. And when we're doing cows, a big area is people quite often get the head wrong and they get the spaces wrong. So that's what we're going to be looking at today. So this is a cow side on, very typical. What can we learn from it? This rectangle represents the body of the cow, and it's roughly equivalent to the chest width. You can see the width of the body relative to how high the body is off the ground. So if we measure this line here, it would come up to about here. These are just guidelines, right? Just like there is no standard human being, there are also no standard cows. Some are a little bit taller than others, and some have longer legs than others. But the key thing is, if you want to draw a cow in your painting, if you make the distance from the bottom of the body to the ground around about 2/3 or a little bit under
the width of the body,
that at least puts the cow in the right position above the ground. Okay, so that's one of the things to keep in mind. There's the head of the cow cropping the grass. There's the bottom of the body. Can you see where the top of the head is? It's sort of almost in line with the bottom of the body. So that gives you an idea of where this point is off the ground, right? So again, this distance here is about 2/3 or a bit less of the height of the body. When drawing the head, it's better to err on the side of drawing it too small rather than too big. And the other thing to note, so here's this rectangle. So I've drawn the rectangle one line at the shoulder and the other at the hips. Now when the cow is cropping the grass, it drops the shoulders a little bit. All right, so now if you want to start to round out some of these shapes, you can see how here's the hips. The hips are higher than the shoulders when it's eating, okay? And then just roughly before you get into that rounding, what you can also do, if you've got the head here, then you just connect this top corner with the top corner of the head and the bottom corner with the bottom corner of the head. It's not a perfect analogy, but it's enough to get you going. And then if you get that right, you'll have something that sort of looks like a stylized cow, and then you can start adding some extra curves. And when I do the demonstration today, you'll see that, you know, especially things like the ears and the forehead. The other thing when you're drawing anything, something else to keep in mind is what we call negative shape.
The negative shapes in this photo are these spaces.
See the space between the head and that forward leg? The gap between these legs, the gap here, the little gap here. They're useful for two things. One, again, it's back to proportion, right? How big is this space relative to this space relative to this space? What does it look like? See, this roughly is a rectangle this way. This is roughly a rectangle, more portrait style. This is more landscape style. This is getting a bit more triangular. And here you have a little triangle. But they're handy to get these shapes right, the positive shapes, which are the shapes of the legs, but also handy to as a test for your drawing, to show you whether or not the body is too long or too short. If you do your drawing of your cow and then you look at this negative shape, and instead of this being a longish shape here, it's more narrow and taller, then you know you haven't made the body long enough or you've made some other part of the cow too long. So that's one of the useful things with negative shapes.
Here's another cow, this time with its head raised.
Again, these proportions are the same. This time, because the cow has got its head up, the legs are a little bit closer together, certainly these ones at the front, because it's not having to lean forward to stretch its neck. The size of the head from here to here is roughly from the bottom of the body down to the ground. So you can just use that as a bit of a guide. And the other proportion you want to have a look at is here. So this sort of like a truncated cone, you look at that shape, it's much more squat than this shape here, where the cow is stretching its neck to get to the grass. You can't always see all four legs, because you know, sometimes this one leg covers the other. By painting on an eighth sheet like this, if you print your photo out to on A4 or letter size, then it's much easier to keep shapes to the right size. So let's have a look. So we'll start with a rectangle, and you can make it a bit bigger if you want. There. One other dimension that's useful to know: if we measure the length of this rectangle, the height is about 2/3 of that. It's just a guide, because cows are different. Different breeds have slightly different dimensions, but it gives you a guide. So if I say I drew a line here and said, okay, my cow is only going to be is that long, but then if I measure that relative to the height, you go, wait a minute, that's the same. So you know that's wrong. So what we do, let's say for this exercise, I want my cow to be, its body to be about that long. If I measure that with my pencil, come up here, and that's a little bit less than 2/3. So I can either shorten the body, or I can just make this a bit longer. There, there, and that's good enough. And now the legs, remember I said the legs are about 2/3 the height, so we just mark that there. And this is where the ground's going to be. And for now, we're just going to put one leg there. I'm going to just mark them very roughly, and another leg here. Obviously, with practice, you don't have to draw these rectangles in. This is just a good learning skill. In time, you'll just go in and draw your cow. Now, for the head, remember I said it's roughly this height, so we can just extend this line here, and we know if I want to position this head here, I can look, if this is the shoulder, I can look at this shape here, and we know that's more of a portrait style, meaning the height is greater than the width. So I can just draw a line there, and that roughly positions the head. This line should be leaning this way. So this is going to come back here. It's better to get these sorted out at this stage. So this is just a very rough approximation of the cow with things near enough to the right position. So now that I've got that, I can go in and draw in some of this detail. So what have we got here? We've got the hip, It dips down a little bit, just a small amount, then it comes back up at the chest cavity. Then it comes down quite a bit here, dips out as the neck stretches down. And then out here, it's got its forehead and ear. I'm not going to worry about the tag. There it comes down, and then the neck. There. And then the brisket. Comes up to this point in the middle, almost the middle of this leg. Then its belly comes down. And an empty looking udder by the looks of it. There. And then this part here. So it's, this would be its thigh. And the knee sticks out just below here. And then it comes back in again. Now don't press too hard when you're doing this because you'll probably need to make some adjustments. Front of the leg, and then we've got a shape, pelvis there, and then we've got some of these darker shapes. I don't want to spend too much on indicating the ribs and that because we'll just paint them in. So this is the spine, and then there's just a dip here for the ribs there, and they've got a strong shadow shape here. There, and then a shadow shape here. That's it. So this leg is fine. And then the back leg, these teats are in the wrong place. We'll put them in later. You can't always see the hooves because of the grass, right? Then we've got this leg at the back. And again, because of linear perspective, and it's not so obvious, but the legs on the front, or this side on, in a side-on view, the front legs are the ones closest to you, will appear just a fraction lower down the paper than the ones on the other side of the cow. Okay, so keep that in mind as well. These are all little things that make your drawing just a little bit more believable. And look at the shape, the negative shape between the tail and the body. You've got a dark spot there. There we go. So our cow is coming together. Now we've got this space. The top part of the leg is much thicker than the bottom part. And you can just see a hint of the hoof there. And then here, you know, obviously this leg goes all the way up to the shoulder, but you can't see much. And you can see how much easier it is to draw this once you've got those basic proportion guidelines in. You can't see much in terms of the eyes, but it'd be somewhere here. I'm going to have a shadow running along here. And that's it. Before I do anything, I'll get rid of some extraneous pencil marks. It's not so critical in this case because we're not doing a background or anything, but that's all. All right, so if we look at our cow, what have we got? We've got a pale beige colour, and then we've got a light brown, and then we've got the dark brown for the shadow. So we're going to mix a dark brown, a light brown that is more reddish than the darker tone brown, and then a pale beige here. They're the three colors. We're going to wet the back. It just will make it so much easier. And I'm using 300 GSM Saunders, so it's going to take quite a bit of wetting. All right, so our dark color is just French ultramarine. And burnt sienna. And again, you notice, drag your brush to test the actual colour. You can see how it's not as dark as what that is there. So we just thicken our paint. That's pretty right. Good, that'll do. Leave that brush there. The lighter tone. Start with lots of burnt sienna, but obviously it's not bright burnt sienna, which means it still needs some French ultramarine to dull it off a bit. That's pretty right. Just a little bit of French ultramarine, but not much. That's pretty good. And the beige is just some, let's go with some raw sienna, or yellow ochre would do as well. You know, I think that's pretty good. All right. So I'll just go in with a light brown. Maybe it needs to be a bit redder than that, meaning just a bit warmer. You know, just in some areas, maybe here. There, a bit more. There. And up here is a bit redder too. There we go. You don't wet the cow shape first, because if you do, all this testing you've done is wasted, because you're going to dilute the colors on the cow. So you just paint, as soon as you paint the cow with this lighter color, everything else after that is wet on wet. There. So it's important to see the process. So this is why you don't need to wet anything, because we're wetting it with the paint. And you keep your spray bottle handy in case it does dry too fast. With the paint sitting there for a while, it stains the paper, so that later when I paint with the beige color, Some of the paint from above will flow into the beige colour, but it will still retain a defined edge, and it gives you a very good connection between the darker brown and the beige colour. I'm leaving like a broken edge at the bottom of the hooves and the bottom of the mouth to read like where the grass is going to go. There's a slightly dark area here. I'll just mark that in. The tail we'll put in now. Something fairly loose like that. There. I lost the negative shape, so I quite often find if you just get a tissue and press on it and leave it there for, you know, 10 seconds or so, it seems to dry the surface moisture well enough that you can go back to creating your hard edges. There we go. Now, I'll pick up some of this extra moisture that I've got sitting down here. And now I'll just go straight into this dark color. And this is back to timing again, because these are sort of soft edges, right? And now I'm just dropping the paint in. So I'm just touching the tip. I've got quite a lot of paint in my brush, touching the tip of the brush to the wet paint. There. I'm going to take out some moisture because I want it. The spine there just has a little bit of dark on it, but I don't want it to bleed all the way down. Then I've got a little mark there. There. And a shape there. There. Shape here. There. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. That'll do. And these legs are quite a bit darker back here. Dark going into lighter. This one's very dark. This is dark. Now you might want to be, I'm pretty good at working with quite wet paint, but you might want to be pick up some paint and just tapping it on a towel to take that extra little bit of moisture out of your brush. All right, that's pretty good, good, good. Yeah. little shadow of the tail. There we go. All right, now put that brush down. I'm going to get another brush, clean it and take out pretty much all the moisture, and then just get rid of some of this excess moisture down here. There. There. And there's the base of the cow. Make it a little bit darker for the teats. Not that dark. There we go. Now, where the paint's flowed more than I wanted, I'll lift some of that colour out. Soften that a bit. There, and then I'll get a size 8 brush, just pick up we need a shadow underneath here to connect the cow to the ground. A few grasses. Because it's wet on wet, you're not going to get much more detail in there than that. This can be lightened on this side. Great. All right. That'll do. You know, it's an exercise. Hopefully it'll give you a good reference to hang on to.